interpreted and properly rigged for the assault. Unit jumpmasters conducted pre-combat inspections and preparations in order to exit the aircraft. The entire assault is the culmination of preparation. Typically, an advanced trauma life support medical team jumps with a task force of this size. After all jumpers land, they will debrief from their final course that has been established. The paratroopers will maneuver to predetermined positions throughout the drop zone and decisively execute their tactical tasks. While in the air, the jumpers will while doing this, they are ensuring that there are no malfunctions, damage to their canopy, or their suspension lines. Prepare to land. At approximately 200 feet above the drop zone, all jumpers lower their combat equipment by pulling their equipment release handle. The equipment will then fall free. This ensures paratrooper can make a safe and unencumbered parachute landing. The jumpers are also ensuring that they explode and they drift laterally as they land, further minimizing the chances of injuries upon landing.
Later this afternoon, and because of the participation of both U.S. and Spanish paratroopers, the exchange that signifies the strong bond of shared courage between paratroopers of all nations. The joint forcible entry capability you have seen today ensures the nations of the NATO alliance have the ability to strike anywhere in the world and achieve decisive victory in response to any number.
Thank you.